Good morning. 안녕하세요.
네, 반갑습니다. 자, 먼저 한국의 시청자들을 위해서요, 이 그린 뉴딜 그룹이 어떤 단체고 무슨 일을 하는 곳인지부터 설명을 좀 부탁드립니다.
Yes, the Green New Deal Group was formed in 2007 when the financial crisis first broke. And in 2008, we published a plan called the Green New Deal. And the point was to address the simultaneous crisis of the price in the oil. The spike in the oil price, some extreme weather that was happening at the moment, the background problem of climate change, and the fact that this was having a huge impact around the world in terms of driving food prices up, and of course the financial crisis itself. So there was a kind of a triple crisis of energy, of climate, and of the financial system. And the Green New Deal Group was a comprehensive economic plan designed to set the economy onto a pathway of radical carbon reduction, and also to do so in a way which generated jobs and rejuvenated the economy, but set it onto this lower carbon trajectory. Since then, we've been meeting regularly, we've been producing new reports looking at the potential of the green economy, of the so-called green collar jobs. And more recently, in the UK, we formed an all-party parliamentary group, which is designed to engage with the whole parliamentary process to push forward the agenda of radical carbon reduction and rejuvenating the economy at the same time.
네. 자, 코로나19로 인한 이 세계 경제 위기 이후에 전 세계 주요 국가들은 위기 극복을 위한 새로운 성장 전략을 추구할 수밖에 없는 상황이 되었습니다. 교수님께서 계신 이 영국에서는 그린 뉴딜 정책이 어떻게 진행이 되고 있나요?
There is a problem in talking about a comprehensive Green New Deal in the UK at the moment, because the UK approach has the problems which many approaches have. And that is, it is almost as if we want to sort of have our planet and eat it, to use an English expression. And that's to say that while there has been an announcement of new spending on green initiatives, in our most recent budget, £4 billion new to go towards a green industrial strategy. At the same time, a lot of money is also being invested into the old carbon intensive economy. For example, we have a £27 billion road program, and we've just recently announced £16 billion to be invested in our military sector. So the amount of money which is going to the green sector is very, very small. It's outweighed by money which is being invested in things which will have the opposite effect. So there is a great deal of new awareness of what needs to happen, but this hasn't yet been translated through into a comprehensive and coherent policy package that could really earn the name of a proper Green New Deal.
이 디지털 분야와 그린 이두 분야는 전 세계적으로 각광을 받고 있는 신산업 분야라고 할 수가 있을 텐데요. 특히 이 중에서 이 그린 뉴딜이 우리에게 가져다 줄수 있는 기대 효과는 무엇이 있을까요?
Well, first thing I'd say is that when we talk about growth, we have the challenge of how to allow the whole global economy to thrive within planetary boundaries. That means that when you talk about growth, it has to be checked that that will be compatible with meeting climate targets. At the moment, in terms of conventional growth, it's very hard to de-link growth from rising carbon emissions enough, even when we talk about digital strategies. So that's the first thing. The second thing is that there are obviously huge efficiency gains that can be made by shifting towards digital strategies. But as the great ecological ecologist Herman Daly says, we can eat further down the food scale, but we cannot eat recipes. And the fact is, in terms of the material composition, the amount of natural resources the global economy is using, well, that's still increasing. So, digital gives us a way forward. It gives us new opportunities, but we still need to look at how we reduce the aggregate, the overall levels of consumption, which are driving things like the climate emergency and the ecological crisis and the loss of species. But digital gives us new opportunities.
네, 대한민국도 이제 선도 국가로 전환하기 위해서 대한민국 대전환, 한국판 뉴딜을 본격적으로 시동을 걸었습니다. 건국 이래 최대 규모의 투자가 이루어질 예정인데요. 자, 앞으로 대한민국이 한국판 뉴딜을 시행하면서 어떤 방향으로 나아가야 할지 조언 한마디 부탁드립니다.
Well, I think South Korea has set an international standard for the boldness of its green stimulus spending. And we saw this back in 2008. Now, I know it wasn't perfect, nothing is. And I know that issues have been raised about some of the impacts and where some of the spending ultimately went. But in terms of boldness and ambition, South Korea is absolutely walking in the right direction. And if I look at the kind of things that you're intending to do at the moment, your expansion of renewable energy, your approach to intelligent microgrid communities, the move towards more electric vehicles and approaches to the circular economy, these are all enormously positive developments. I think maybe some of the challenges that South Korea is going to face is whether it can move further and faster in terms of getting fossil fuels out of its energy system, if it can have a more ambitious target for carbon reduction measures, which are in line with the climate science. And this is going to mean moving forward the targets for getting to zero carbon. And I think ultimately, one of the challenges for many advanced industrial economies like South Korea is that we need different models to aspire to. I have to say that Korean television, so-called K-dramas, are very popular in my household. And if you turn them on, you quite often see these luxury, high-consumption lifestyles. And you see people driving large sports utility vehicles, 4x4s. I think the challenge for Korea is not unique to Korea, but it does apply to Korea, is how can we imagine lifestyles and ways of being which are more in line with living within planetary boundaries and meeting our climate targets? So many of the things which the country is doing are an example to others, but we still need to go further and faster to align with the climate science. And I think we need a new idea of how we can experience well-being and enjoy good lives whilst not crossing crucial ecological and climate boundaries.
네, 지금까지 서섹스 대학 앤드류 심스 교수와 얘기를 나눠봤습니다.